new session of CE class. Children, you remember me saying, speak in English, speak in English? I know, because you often keep hearing me saying that. Why do I say that? I want you to speak in English very fluently. I want you to speak in English very fluently. How do we do that? Now I will tell you how to do it. Let me ask you, which is the very common language that you speak at home? Is it English? No, it is Malayalam. How did you learn Malayalam? Before you came to school itself, you know to speak Malayalam, isn't it? How did you learn it? Did you write and learn? No. You learned it by listening to others. You listen to your parents, you listen to your family members, you listen to your friends, and so on. So that is how you learn different languages. So you will be learning English also in the same way. But for that you have to listen. That is the first thing that you have to do when you are starting to learn a new language. Next thing is to practice. If you simply listen in one ear and just leave it out through the other, it is not going to work out. So listen and practice so that you could be very well an expert in English. Why do you want to learn English? Because English will make you feel a little more confident. Because English is the most common language that is spoken all around the world. There are various listening practices that you can follow to improve your language. Like you can watch animated stories, you can watch animated cartoons, but not in Malayalam, in English. You are all well versed in Malayalam, I know. But let us start to speak in English fluently. Before I start with the main topic, there are certain etiquettes and manners that you have to follow, not only in your house but also in your school. So how do we do that? I am going to take you through each situation one by one. So are you ready? Let's begin with our situations. Imagine you are all back to school. You are all seated inside your classroom. You have finished with meditation. Then you go with Guru Vandanam. Then the assembly continues. After the assembly, what is the first thing your teacher does? Any idea? Yes, it is the attendance. Your teacher takes attendance. Now, let me see how the students are going to respond when a teacher is taking the attendance. Sheba.
Prasad.
Julia.
Yes, sir, teacher.
Now, you understood the situation, right? I am taking attendance. And did you hear how Sheba responded to the attendance? She said, present. And how did Julia say? She said, present, teacher. So which one is the right one? Yes, you have to say present, teacher, and not just say present. So first thing, whenever a teacher is taking attendance, is you have to be very attentive. You have to listen to her carefully. Only then you can hear, isn't it? So let us try once again how Sheba is going to respond. Okay? Sheba.
Present, teacher.
See, Sheba has changed. She has responded it very well. She has changed to present, teacher. Isn't it? Hope you all come back soon and the teacher starts taking attendance live. And this is how you will respond. You will never say present. You will say present, teacher. So this is one of the basic manner that you have to follow as a student in the class. Okay? So can we move on to the next one? Imagine you all are inside the classroom. Your teacher is taking a class. She began reading the chapter and she keeps repeating the concepts. After some time, she asks you, Deepa, did you understand?
Yes.
Is that the way of telling? Now let me ask Shruti. Shruti, did you understand?
Yes, teacher.
Good. See how Shruti responded? This is how you have to respond when a teacher is asking you a question. You will never say yes. That's wrong. So let me see if Deepa is going to say it again. Deepa, did you understand?
Yes, teacher.
Very good. I appreciate Deepa for understanding. This is how you have to respond to a teacher. Now suppose I am your mother. Okay? I am at your home. I am going to ask again. Deepa, did you eat your breakfast?
Yes, mom.
See, Deepa has learned the way of responding to somebody who is elder to her. So not just to your mother, not just to your teacher. Whenever you are responding to any elderly person, you have to speak with respect. So that is one of the most common manner that you have to follow, not just in your house, even in your school or anywhere outside. So next time, whenever an elderly person is asking you something, will you speak with respect? Not just say yes. You say yes, teacher, or yes, mother, or yes, father, yes, grandma, yes, granddad, and so on. So can we see the next situation? All of you are busy listening to the class what your teacher is taking. All of a sudden, you feel thirsty, isn't it? How do you take permission from teacher? I can hear somebody whispering over there. Deepa, what did you say?
May I drinking water?
Listen, students, what did Deepa say? She asked, may I drinking water? Is that the right way of saying? I think I have repeatedly said something in the class. Every time, whenever you feel thirsty, how will you ask? Shruti, tell me, how will you ask?
Teacher, may I drink water?
Absolutely. This is how you have to ask permission when your teacher is taking class. How will you ask? May I drink water, or can I have a sip of water, please? So, I hope next time you will correct yourself whenever you are asking permission from your teacher. Okay? Similarly, when you are at home, you want to ask permission from your mother. You want to go out and play. How will you ask? You will ask, may I go out and play, mother? See, I know you will ask this only in Malayalam, but try this at home in English also. Your mother is also going to have a lot of fun. Okay? So, I want you all to practice. So, what did I say earlier? You have to listen and practice this regularly. Only then you can become fluent in English. Okay? So, what did we learn today? We learned, how will you respond when a teacher is taking attendance in your class? Right? The second one, how will you behave when an elderly person is asking you something? Lastly, how you will ask permission to your teacher or to anyone in your home whenever you want to do something. So next time I will be dealing with many more such etiquettes and manners as to how you have to behave or how you have to speak while you are in school and at home. So until we meet next time, this is Jamshida teacher taking leave. Take care and have a nice day.